hybrid cloud is one of the most common architectural patterns out there, but it's generally actually the result of companies that are unable to abandon an existing technology stack in favor of the public cloud. But what if I told you could get the best of both worlds? The innovation and cutting-edge technologies made possible through public cloud providers, and at the same time, having the flexibility and freedom of running your assets where you choose to, whether it's on-prem or edge. Today, let's talk about distributed cloud and the key benefits that it offers. Now, I want to start with what a general hybrid cloud architecture looks like. So you're going to have customers that are running things on on-prem environments. Maybe they're running things on public cloud environments, or even private clouds, or even in addition, we might have edge environments. Now, managing all of these environments comes with their own set of ops teams, challenges, data locality, latency concerns. Basically, all of them will require some overhead to maintain. Distributed cloud comes in right at the center. Essentially, what you'll have is a public cloud sitting right at the center that's able to manage all of those other environments. Essentially, it extends the capabilities of a public cloud to other capabilities. Now, I think Gartner put it best when they said that in a report that they recently published, they said that distributed cloud fixes what hybrid cloud breaks. Now, today I want to cover four major themes that generally correspond with what distributed cloud aims to solve, and these actually happen to line up with where hybrid cloud tends to fall short. Now, the first one that I want to start with is consistency. Now, as I go through the example today, I'm going to put on a number of different hats, whether I'm dev, ops, or security. And I want to start with an ops engineer, because an ops engineer will generally have to be kind of interfacing with a distributed cloud environment, and that's where they will generally start. So as an ops engineer, let's say that one of the first things that I want to do is work with a cloud environment. So what I want to do is go to a public cloud, and in that environment, let's say that I want to create a Kubernetes or even an OpenShift cluster. So basically, a way to manage and orchestrate cloud-based applications. Now, in this process of creating an OpenShift cluster, I'm probably given an option at one point to choose where do I want this cluster to live. So here's where I'm given a few choices. So maybe I want to do it in a public cloud location. So let's say, for example, somewhere like Dallas or London. But through a distributed cloud, I can register with the public cloud other locations. So maybe somewhere like an on-prem or edge location. So let's say I've got an on-prem location in Bangalore. Or an edge location in Morocco. So basically what we've got here is whether it's public, on-prem, or edge locations, we can choose one of those capabilities directly in my public cloud UI and dashboard. That's what a distributed cloud will generally offer. So through this process, I'm now able to deploy OpenShift container platform clusters in three different regions, let's say. So we've got three different OCP clusters. We'll say one of them is in public. We'll say one of them is in edge. And we'll say the last one is on-prem. Okay, so we've got that kind of situated from an ops engineering perspective. I'm able to create and manage clusters across the board, whether they're in any of these general hybrid cloud style environments. Now, as an ops engineer, that might be good for day one, but for day two, I need additional capabilities. Let's say that I want to do something like scaling up and down. Well, that's one of the key advantages of a cloud is the elasticity. So let's say I can scale up and down. And in addition, let's say I want my clusters to be able to network and interface with one another, basically communicate my applications communicating across the board. So maybe I want to take advantage of a service mesh capability. That's something a distributed cloud can offer. So taking a look at that, we can start doing some service meshing capabilities. Okay, so now that we've got that groundwork laid out, we've covered how basically for an ops engineer, I have a consistent experience for deploying clusters in any of these locations. We have consistency. Next up, let's talk about DevOps. So we've covered a bit of DevOps already, so with the ops perspective of deploying and managing clusters. But for developers who want to utilize capabilities generally available in public clouds, well, I have a different angle of approach here. So putting on my hat as a dev, now let's say one of the first things that I want to do here is create a service, right? So generally with OCP, most DevOps capabilities are handled. It's a really good platform for being able to work with containers and kind of deploying apps. But let's say I want to take advantage of a service that cloud providers generally provide. So this would be something like a database. So I want to create a DB. So I'm in my cloud provider, I'm in the dashboard, and I want to create a database. And I'm given a similar option. I'm asked, where do you want to create it? And so I'm given options like before, data centers or locations, not just public cloud, but also on-prem or edge. And I can choose to deploy those high-value capabilities, you know, so I can decide to deploy a database in my public cloud. Well, this is nothing special. I've been able to do that. Or I should be able to deploy a database in addition into edge environments. So that's taken care of as well. So now that we've gotten that piece kind of squared away, we've kind of talked about how distributed cloud enables DevOps to be more efficient. One other thing I want to use this example for here. It's innovation. And this is for high value services. So let's say I want to do AI or machine learning capabilities, something that a public cloud will generally offer. So, you know, let's say I have some AI or ML capabilities that I want to deploy. Well, same as before, I can take those capabilities and deploy them to any of these environments. So with distributed cloud, you're able to innovate with capabilities generally only available in public cloud in environments outside of the public cloud. It's one of the key capabilities. The last one I want to talk about today is governance. Now, governance is a key requirement for pretty much all companies, but especially, you know, financial institutions or health or insurance companies. Basically, concerns like data regulations, compliance, data locality. How can a security admin effectively and with a single control plane manage policies across the board? Well, time to put on my last hat here. Let's say that I'm a security admin and I've created a network policy. So this network policy, let's say that it handles things like RBAC or network policies across the board or security policies. And I want to deploy them to clusters everywhere in my business, not just in the cloud, but also on-prem and edge. Well, with a distributed cloud, you can do exactly that. By taking advantage of the capabilities made available, I can deploy these policies across the board to any of these environments. Now, this is a simple example, but it goes to show you how distributed cloud is tackling problems that hybrid cloud generally runs into. Thanks for joining me for this quick overview of distributed cloud. If you've enjoyed this video and you want to see more like this in the future, be sure to drop a like or a comment below. To see what IBM is doing in the distributed cloud space, be sure to check out IBM Cloud Satellite. Thank you for watching.